is joining us tonight. Yeah, we love you. You did a very cool thing. You recently made a surprise return to WWE SmackDown.
Dude,
first time since 2019. How'd that feel?
It was incredible. So here's the crazy thing about that is we were in Boulder. I was there for College Game Day, and I found out the night before that WWE SmackDown is going to be in Denver, which is right up the road. So I call my buddies at WWE, Nick Khan, and I said, hey, man, I heard SmackDown here. Can you confirm that? He said, it is. I said, good. Well, The Rock is coming to SmackDown. And I went out there, and it was really an incredible thing. And I've been really lucky over the years to entertain in a lot of different ways.
Yeah.
But that kind of connection with a WWE audience, by the way, that kind of connection is just like this tonight with a live audience. There's nothing like it.
Nothing like a live.
There's nothing like it. So my music hit, If You Smell, and I went out there. And
they had no idea. No.
They had no idea, and you guys know how hard it is to keep a secret.
Right? It doesn't exist anymore.
It doesn't exist. This was a full-on secret. The people went nuts. 13,000 people, sounded like 130,000 people, and it was just incredible. So WWE audience, it's my family, and I love them, and it was incredible.
Yeah, you said that.
And by the way, I gotta say, not only is that connection just like this incredible, but there's nothing like going to SmackDown and laying the SmackDown on their candy asses all night long.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah. It all started with your dad, with Rocky Johnson. Here's you and your dad.
He
would have been proud, huh, to see what's going on.
You know, we've talked about this, and my dad was a real game changer in the world of pro wrestling. He was one half of the first black WWE tag team champions in 1983, and it was really amazing. And he was one of my heroes. And he unfortunately passed away suddenly like that, and I never got a chance to say goodbye to him. So any opportunity that I could go back to wrestling and in a way pay homage to my dad, my grandfather, I got a lot of family in wrestling, is always very, very special.
Yeah, that's super cool, bud. Yeah. I always appreciate you coming on the show. And now with the SAG strike over, you're allowed to talk about movies, which I'm so happy.
We are back. Hollywood is back.
Man.
Yes.
So happy.
Yes, I'm so happy.
So happy they got a deal.
I'm so happy for our actors. I'm so happy for our SAG, my fellow SAG members. I'm so happy that we're back. And for the crew getting back to work.
Let's go.
And especially during the holidays, so it's awesome.
Yes, exactly right. I wanted to ask you about this, and I don't even know if you can talk about it, but there's talk about a live-action Moana in the works.
Yes.
And is it true? Is it happening? Something that you...
My next project that I will be shooting is a live-action version of Moana.
You would definitely do it. You're Maui.
I am.
You're real-life Maui.
I am the real-life Maui. Thank you guys very much. So excited about this. And in a way, again, it's like it's a way to pay homage to not only my Polynesian heritage and culture, and also it's just such an... As you guys know, it's just such an incredible story that resonates with everybody around the world, especially young girls and empowering young girls of just... You know, there's what's in front of you, and then it's the stuff we teach our kids. There's what's in front of you, and then there's the stuff that you can't see that's way out there. And have faith and confidence in who you are, and go out there, even if you can't see it. And Moana happens to meet the demigod Maui, who helps her see that, and she helps him. So I can't, it's going to be, oh, and by the way, Tommy Kail is going to direct it,
Hamilton? And
he directed Hamilton, the incredible Hamilton.
He's unbelievable.
He's incredible. And
Lin-Manuel?
I got to say, coming back to do all the music of Moana is Lin-Manuel Miranda. Amazing. So, dude, I cannot wait. And here's the thing, Jimmy, listen. I can go on and on. I can explain every natural phenomenon. The tide, the grass, the ground. Oh, that was Maui just messing around. I could have nailed, I buried it, spouted a tree, now you got coconuts. What's the lesson? What is the takeaway? Don't mess with Maui when he's on a breakaway. And the tapestry here on my skin is the map of the victors I win. Look where I've been, I make everything happen. Look at that mini Maui just tickety-tapping. Ha, 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 ha. Hey!
What can I say?